Fact, there is fuel left over, but
very little.
But that's why they make it for safety as well, just that's if you don't want to put a bigger tank in.
And of course, it's all wet.
Charlie and Wife.
Lean out device, which is driver activated.
The other grounds are full.
The but basically you've got your controls are obviously steering, throttle pedal, clutch pedal. This is a brake. That's a hand brake lever operating on the rear brakes. This is reverse gear.
Okay.
This is fuel shut off. That's your parachute activation. First gear, so that's first to second gear shift. That's second to third gear shift. And then these two buttons power up the car.
And is there these buttons, they pull out or push in?
Pull out, both buttons out is first gear.
Yeah.
That button in is second gear. And then that button in is third gear.
And you've got to be able to, obviously the amount of the G's involved in the vibrations and movement of the car mean that you have to have something that's fairly easy to hold on to and to do things incredibly quickly.
Your
gear changes are going to be instrumental.
And then those gear changes are CO2 activated. So these CO2 towers are just inside there is a piston, which so when I hit the button, it drives the piston down, tightens the band, which changes the gear. And then they're full power shifts, you know. There's, at no point should you or would you want to come off that throttle.
Yes, absolutely.
Once you've put the throttle to the floor on the start line, you're not looking to come off it until the finish line, unless you have to.
Yes, absolutely, yeah. And all of the mechanics for the gear changes allows you to basically do that.
All power shifts.
So I think he's had enough in there because he put some water the other one.
Yeah.
But I don't know how long he's going to run it for. So.
There'll be loads in there.
Well, I suppose run it. So you take it the same way then, just sucking it, but you've got electric pump.
That one has got a bung underneath that would just drain it out. This one,
that's the computer box.
I can't remember because we've only taken this to the track once.
And then data-wise,
all you need is just a small electric pump.
We're monitoring various functions on the car.
With a drill, it's so quick at least, because it's low, you can't lift it up otherwise.
This one is clutch RPM, this one is drive shaft RPM.
And if you want and when to call, you look at those, that's data.
You can put the one in now.
Yeah, you can tell. If your crankshaft RPM and your drive shaft RPM aren't the same, then you've got losses somewhere. And that's the intermediate. That measures the first motion shaft. So that's how you can tell that you're not achieving clutch lockup or what point you're achieving. Because this is all in real time.
Yes, of course.
So you can look at those graphs with relation to what's going on in real time down the track.
Great. Are you going to use the fire up today to give you a little bit of information? Stuff that you
can... No, we're not monitoring today. This is just a purely... both cars have had quite a major rebuild, and this is just to make sure they work and don't leak.
No,
this car's going out first, so we'll be racing that one in 3 weeks' time. At a nostalgia meeting.
Nice. In the UK?
Said we were going to build a new car, I kind of said to myself it wouldn't be at the expense of this one, so I didn't want to take even anything off that car. But little did I realise the time and financial implications of that. But this car, in development terms, you can see it's a physically bigger car than that, and yet it comes in some 80 kilos made of chrome molybdenum tube, which is aircraft steel. Because that tube in that car is say 32 ton tensile, and this material is 72 ton tensile, it's twice as strong, so you can use less tube, thinner metal. So, and you can see the front end design. This one's quite wide and that one's narrow. But that actually is pretty much nothing more than weight saving.
Right.
You know, that front end weighs more than that front end. That's it, really. You only need enough to give your steerage way down the track, of course.
Kenny.
Is that enough in there?
No, I'll get some more, because I think, because they often run that for quite a long time.
Need that mark.
I don't know, just see that that'll get upgraded to the start, and it will, won't it?
Thank you.
actually, just another piece of history made today. I've never had two cars in a running condition, and I've never had two cars actually running. So, yeah, in Team Triple R, it's a first today, and we're very happy with how it went.
Keep down yourself.